Hi everyone, welcome to the fourth video, and here we will talk about some interesting questions. So let me ask you the questions about the ES6. What is let cons, what is arrow functions, what is spread operator, rest parameter, how we import export the modules in ES6, how we do the inheritance with the classes like class A is extending class B, what all different things are there in ES6, what are the new features are there and how to use them, and how they are making your life easier, like cloning the objects. You can use a spread operator, triple dot. Cloning the array, you can use a triple dot to create a copy or deep clone of an array. Okay, how you can merge the two array using concat method in the array.prototype.concat, right? There are a lot of questions can be there. So let's talk about some general questions about hoisting, about closures, about the prototypal inheritance in JavaScript, how a function can call another functions using the call method function.call. Okay, what is hoisting and how it works? What is hoisting is just a mechanism in which, if you are using a var keyword in JavaScript, if you are declaring any variable using var keyword, then that variable is hoisted to the top of the function definition. So consider you have a variable outside the function var x10, and you have the variable inside the function var x20 at line number 10, and you put a console.log before the start, after the just after the starting of function. What will be the value of that x inside the function? It will not get the value from the outside of the function, because function already know x is defined somewhere in my body, but I don't have the value. So variable inside the function is hoisted to the top of the function definition. That's why function knows variable x is defined in my body, so I will not accept the value coming from the outside. That is the hoisting. Hoisting of functions is there, hoisting of variables is there in JavaScript ES5. How do you do compare two objects? You can write just a compare method. You just stringify both the objects and compare the strings, or you keep iterating on each and every properties, all these things. Okay. Important question is, you might have heard about if block, immediately invoking functional block, which is, I can write the code. So this is the immediately if block, right? So why we use it? This we use to create a module pattern, okay? It create a closure around the entire code. So right now we are not putting the JavaScript script tag and start writing the code. We should always put whatever the code we are writing inside a if block. So it actually creating the closures entire the component, which creates a private namespace, so that the variables function name you are declaring inside if block will not get conflict with the outside script modules. Okay, what is the difference between null and undefined? You already know the type of null, and null is object, type of undefined is raw undefined. Okay, and null and undefined double equals will be true, but triple equals will be false, because in triple equals we are checking type and value. Okay, what are the ways of creating an object? There are multiple ways. You can use object.create, you can use the function constructor, or you can use a factory method. You can use object literal, simply curly braces to create an object, or you can create one object from another object using object.create, object.assign. Creating new object is possible through the constructor function using new keyword. JavaScript is passed by value or reference. It depends on the uses. JavaScript always passed by value. However, with the object, the value is a reference to the object which we are passing. Okay, this is an important one. Other questions in JavaScript are there are new huge number of questions, right? So they may give you just a simple problem statement about array, and you should be aware about what all different calculations you can do on array. So you should be aware about map, filter, reduce, all these methods for each, sum, every, full, from, array.from, or the new methods introduced in ES6. Okay, what are mutables methods, what are immutable methods? Like array.slice0 will give you a clone of an array. Array.map, array.filter are immutable, means they don't change the existing array, they will always return the new array after doing the calculation. Array.reduce, similarly, how you can freeze an object so that you cannot change anything. So you can use object.freeze, pass the object. So in that case, that object is freeze. When you declare a value with a const, doesn't make the object as a freeze. You can still change the properties inside object. So you need to use object.freeze, or while creating the object properties, you define three things, enumerable, configurable, and writable. So just make all these two properties, writable and configurable, false, so that those properties will not be able to change. Okay, that's it. Let's see more questions in the next video.